Light, the fastest thing in the universe. It is impossible for anything with mass to travel faster than it, or even at the same speed as it. But yet, Terragens are able to keep their massive empires connected. So, how is it possible that Terragens can quickly hop from system to system in a matter of days, and can communicate near instantly between thousands of light years? The answer is wormholes. What are wormholes? Wormholes are spherical points in space that connect distances in space-time. If a mass greater than the wormhole tries to enter it, the wormhole will collapse into a black hole. There are two types of wormholes that are commonly used in the Terragen Sphere: traversable wormholes and calm wormholes. Traversable wormholes, also known as Morse Thorn Cufftick wormholes, are large and are used to transport ships and large physical objects, while calm wormholes are used to transport data and information. There are four main parts of a traversable wormhole. The first part is the transition area. This area is the part where space begins to curve into the wormhole, and it is 327 AU in radius. Because of this, traversable wormholes have to be located far from any stars or planets. When you get within 3 AU of the wormhole, you enter the second zone, the vortex. In this zone, space-time begins to close in around the ship, and relativistic effects can be very harmful if you are not careful. Then, the ship passes a layer called the caustic. It is some sort of thin layer of exotic matter or energy that holds the wormhole open. Without it, the wormhole would collapse into a black hole. Finally, there is the throat at the center of the wormhole, which is where ships pass through. The whole travel process takes a couple of months. The second type are communication wormholes, aka Hayward class wormholes. As the name suggests, these are mostly used for communication and are usually very small. Since they are so small, they can be placed near planets and stars. They are extremely massive for their size. A calm wormhole that is only 2 nanometers wide would mass almost as much as the asteroid Hygieia. These wormholes are essential, as they allow fast communication between the different parts of an archelect's mind and between distant systems. Wormholes can collapse if not monitored by a transapient. Even small instabilities can collapse a wormhole. Causing a time paradox or violating causality also collapses wormholes. So, wormholes must be transported carefully, in special ships called line layers. Despite all these restrictions, wormholes have connected the Terragen Sphere through a giant web called the Nexus, and form the basis of Terragen civilization. Without them, travel and communication between star systems would be much slower. So, how are wormholes created? Wormholes are created by advanced intelligences in structures called whale forges. These whale forges require a massive amount of energy that is gathered through collection swarms or reactors. Whale forges are huge devices that in total can be millions of kilometers wide. At the center of a whale forge, there is a space called the extraction core, which is around a meter wide. The outer part of the extraction core consists of rings made of magma spinning very fast. Inside these rings is a strange object known as a prism. There is also another strange object known as the extraction kernel. Finally, there is the seed, a small piece of mag matter 20 to 30 microns in diameter that is used as a target to form a wormhole. Stretching millions of kilometers out from the extraction kernel are a series of accelerators known collectively as the wormhole production module. To form a wormhole, it accelerates particles at very fast speeds into the seed, creating energies close to the Big Bang. A vacuum fluctuation forms and a caustic is folded by the extraction kernel to keep the wormhole open. The wormhole starts off microscopic, but it can be adjusted to a bigger size. Then, the wormhole ends are transported to their desired locations. This is how a traversable wormhole is formed, but calm wormholes require much smaller wave forces. Thanks for watching this basic guide to wormholes in a way. Goodbye, explorers!